Hi, I'm the Space Quest Historian. Now that I've showed you all of the Space Quest games in short, condensed spurts, it's time I let you in on a little secret. This is not how the games were supposed to look. This is how the games were supposed to look. Allow me to bore the tits off of you for a moment and talk about aspect ratio and why it's such a fucking nightmare. So, Space Quests 1 through 5 run in a resolution of 320 by 200, a mere postage stamp in comparison to the full HD or 4K resolutions we're used to today. But the screens we used to view these games on back in the day weren't the lovely, flat, high-quality, pixel-perfect screens of today. We used to call them monitors, and they were in a 4:3 aspect ratio. Think of those old TVs you see in 80s movies or on Stranger Things. The ones where the picture is more or less square. It's not totally square, but it definitely isn't wide like we're used to today. Now, 320 by 200 is a wide resolution, but on these old monitors, the image would actually stretch vertically to fit on the screen to make the resolution somewhere around 320 by 240. And adding 40 pixels extra to the height makes a big difference, as you can tell. For one, it makes Roger here look a lot less like a chunky boy, and it makes the planets in Space Quest 3 actually look like circles instead of ovals. The only problem is, this is actually pretty tricky to do on modern computers. See, a pixel is the smallest unit on a screen that we have. To get a crisp image in the correct aspect ratio, we have to stretch the image while still keeping the number of pixels the same, which you could do on an old cathode ray tube monitor because it doesn't give two shits about what resolution the image is. It's just a lovely, blurry, potentially headache-inducing image produced by a series of tubes. Again, I'm not technology connections, but the point is, stretching an image and keeping the amount of pixels the same is fundamentally impossible to do on a modern display. A pixel can't be any other size than it is. What we could do is just simply ask the computer to automatically add an extra 40 pixels of height to the image. For instance, by running the game in ScumVM and ticking this little box that says Aspect Correction. But as you can see, this is far from an ideal solution. What it's doing here is looking at the original image, then doubling a handful of the horizontal lines so it fills out to the new height. And the end result just looks like a mess. Doubling some of the lines just makes it all look jagged and weird, and I mean, just look at the text here. Now, we can mitigate it somewhat. In ScumVM, we can turn on a filter that smooths out the image. And while this does look a little bit better, it has the downside of blurring the image. And while blur might make for a more authentic CRT monitor-like experience, I prefer a crisp image. So what can we do? Well, this wonderful blog post from Philippe Pepe suggests that instead of trying to make 320 by 200 look like 320 by 240 through trickery and blurring, we can just upscale the image until the individual pixels become their intended height, however large that may be. As it turns out, that becomes an image of a whopping 1600 by 1200. Yowza! Oh well, hey, at least this means that if we tell DOSBox here to output its display in a resolution of 1600 by 1200 and select a renderer that doesn't blur the shit out of the image, so piss off OpenGL if you please, we get a lovely, crisp, larger-than-fucking-life version of Space Quest 3 in the proper aspect ratio. Here's my next problem, though. My screen resolution isn't big enough to contain the awesomeness currently on display. But that's a minor issue, I'm sure you'll agree, and running the game in full screen will solve all of that, but no, wait, it just kills DOSBox stone dead. But that's on my end. I'm sure if you have a display with the resolution that can cope with it, you'll be fine. Anyway, that's just a short little addendum about why I didn't bother with having the proper aspect ratio in my videos. Well, actually, the truth is I didn't even realize it was this way until deep into the editing process, and I thought, fuck it, who'll notice? So, here we are. Bottom line, more than likely, you're playing your DOS games wrong, but fixing them is a bit of a hassle, and you need a ginormous screen to get the crisp image that doesn't make your eyesight wobble. So, thanks for coming to my TED Talk. I'm the Space Quest Historian. I'll see you around the Chrono Stream. Bye.